to the Stateless Codecast. We're going to continue our series on contributing to Rails, picking up where we left off last time. So in this, we're going to work on updating the changelog, and then we're going to open a GitHub issue and a pull request to solve it. So you can see here the way you update the changelog requires you to reference the GitHub issue. So we're going to get those most of the way done, and then we're going to open the issue and add the issue back in for both the git commit and the changelog. So I'm going to pull up our editor. This is our local version, not on Vagrant. So we're going to go over to railties here, and this is the changelog for railties. We'll go in here, and only a couple have been added here, so we're going to make our changes here. I'll pause for a moment and write them out. So here's my written out change to the changelog. I noted that I've modified the scaffold generator, and what issue it fixes, and then I'll create the issue now on GitHub and replace this 1234 with my actual issue. So we're back on the contributing to Rails guide here. Generic templates. That is not. We'll just go in and write it manually. So Rails. Go here. Issues. New issue. Oh, and it gives you the steps to reproduce here. So we'll fill this out. When we go in, you can go in and the preview section here, it'll be in Markdown, and then we can go in and add our code snippets. So we'll be able to do things like this. Paste in our snippet. So one of the things you can do here in the preview, we'll see it in the preview, is you can put in a snippet of Ruby and we'll be able to fill that out. So I'll pause and write this out, and then we'll come back and review what I did before I submit it. Unpause here. I've written the body of my item here in Markdown, and I'm actually going to go over to the Rails mailing list and propose the solution so I can link to it in the GitHub issue before I submit it. So that's what I'm going to do now. But essentially, I provided the summary of what expected would happen, what is actually happening with a vowel sound, and then proposals for a fix. So we'll head over to Ruby on Rails here, and we'll create a new topic with a feature proposal. So new topic. See active support. So I'm going to see if there's a cancel this and see if there's another option for I guess that is the best option. Go back and create this. This format. I'll write this out and pause and come back to it. All right, I've got my feature proposal written out. I'll submit this and then include a link to it on the GitHub issue. So, create topic. Link to this in my issue here. Works. All right, so I'll submit this. And submit my new issue. Add this number back to my pull request or my changelog request. So got that. Go in just going to here, take a look at our log. And we'll now rebase against master and reword our git commit here. So now we'll amend our commit. So add in here. That works. All right, so now we're going to git fetch, git status. And we're going to force push. We will now go into back into GitHub, go to my version of Rails. Here's our commit. We will now open a pull request. On the Rails repo. Here's my pull request. I will create a new pull request. class forks. So my branch here. Oop. I'll create the pull request, but I don't anticipate that this will go in unchanged anyway, so we'll start the pull request. Look at this. Fine. Create the pull request. Go back to my issue that I created. Ensure that the pull request is now referenced here, and this is where we'll stop and wait for feedback on the fix and the issue, and we'll see where this takes us.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding. And don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.